9 square proportions. This question from previous homework genuinely stumped me. So here we have a triangle with sides 12, 5, and 30. And we see that BD is the angle bisector of angle ABC. And our goal is to find the length for DC. But before we start with the angle bisector theorem, I will have to tell you that this cannot be a triangle in the first place. Let me explain. Notice that this side is 12, this side is 5. When they add up, we get what? 17. 17 is not bigger than 30. So in fact, this is not a valid picture. I will tell you that this right here can't be a triangle because 12 plus 5, this right here, it's not bigger than 30. You have to make sure that the sum of any two sides of a triangle has to be greater than the third side. So, what do we do though? Well, according to the post, this is just a recreation. So, I'm just assuming that maybe the person miswrote the sum number wrong. So, I'm going to change the 30 to another number. So, let's do this one instead. So, let's just pick 15. Again, this side has to be bigger than 12 because this is apparently longer than that. But this right here has to be less than the sum of this and that, so 17. Okay, so let's do this one instead. And CD is right here. Okay, so how do we solve it? Well, here is the angle bisector theorem that I would like to remind you. Angle bisector theorem, which says the following. When we have a triangle, right? Doesn't matter what kind of triangle that we have, but this looks like an equilateral, so it's too perfect. I don't want that. So let's take a look right here instead, something like this. Angle bisector, let's say we have something like this. So this and that are congruent. I'm going to label this as little a, little b, right? Just the sides. And this is little c, little d. Angle bisector theorem says when we do a over b, we must get c over d. Ah, very nice, huh? So with that being said, we can solve this pretty easily. If you want to see a proof of this, I'll make another video later on. But to solve this, I don't know how long this is. Let's just call that x. And because the whole thing from here to here is 15, this much is x already. So from here to here must be 15 minus x. Okay? Imagine if this is 4, this will be 11, add up to be 15. So now, 12 over that, so we have 12 over 15 minus x, that has to be equal to 5 over x. And just solve it. So this times that. 12 times x, that's 12x, that's equal to 5 times that. 5, and put down parentheses for the 15 minus x. So this is 12x, we will distribute first. So 5 times 15 is 75, 5 times that is negative 5x. And then let's just add a 5x on both sides. This and that cancel. And we see that 17x equals 75. And finally, just divide 75 on, just divide 17 on both sides. That's pretty much it. X, which is the length of DC, that's equal to 75 over 17. So that's the answer. And now let me just mention that if earlier we applied the angle bisector theorem to this picture, you can still solve for CD and you get about like 6.8 something. But that answer is meaningless because the triangle didn't even make sense in the first place. So when we are doing geometry, we have to be extra careful with the numbers that we are dealing with. Sometimes when we're doing equations, if you end up with square root of a negative number, you can use complex number, yeah? Yeah, but when you're doing geometry, if you have a bad triangle in the first place, I don't think you can end up with a complex triangle. So anyway, that's it.